Is everything okay? You look a little lost.
Hmm? Oh, yes. I can't seem to find my way home, is all. I was just about to make my umpteenth attempt at a new route.
I was hoping to head this way myself. The situation is a real pain, huh?
I suppose the Sovereign knows best. I daren't stay here too long, though. A lower caste can only linger around these parts for so long before I outstay my welcome. I was hoping to avoid it, but maybe I'll have to go that way after all.
You mean you know another way round?
Lord Dohalim Ilkaris! But how? Last I heard, you were in Dana competing in the crown contest.
Yes, strange, isn't it? If you know another route, we'd be grateful if you could tell us.
But of course. Please forgive me. There's a wall that sprung up ahead of here, with what looks to be an entrance in it. I thought maybe it was a passageway between the different quarters, but I've no way of knowing for sure.
It's worth investigating, at least. I shall go and assess the situation. In the meantime, wait for me here. If it looks safe, I'll come and let you know.
You'd really do that for me? A lord troubling himself for someone of my lowly status?
Our lot in life is of little consequence. We are both Renan, first and foremost.
Oh, why yes, my lord. Thank you.
Well, we've canvassed the city for information. What do you think?
No one has the faintest idea what's happened to the city after all. They haven't heard the news about the crown contest either.
You'd think that info would easily find its way up here. Has it always been like that?
Not to this extent, which would indicate that something's suppressing the truth. That Lenegus is under some kind of control.
Given everything that's happened to their city, the people here seem weirdly okay with it all.
Yeah, that one guy even said Azugul had stopped listening to him. If that's true, these people are in big trouble.
Everything that happens here is attributed to the Sovereign's will. It's the way people have been conditioned. Their belief runs deep. Nothing happens devoid of a reason. To them, it's all part of the Sovereign's grand plan.
The Sovereign's plan. There is one thing I'm still not sure about. Just who is this person ruling over Lenegus?
The Sovereign, of course. He rules from Renna while presiding over both Renna and Lenegus.
Without the lords or anyone in the middle doing his dirty work? Isn't Renna at least the same size as Dana? That's a pretty big dominion for one person to rule over. I would have thought ruling Lenegus alone would be difficult enough.
and the points you make are valid, though I confess I'd never given it much thought before. Here, the Sovereign's total authority is as natural as night turning to day. Come to think of it, I know nothing of the nature of how Rena itself is. Xion, have you ever been... No, forgive me. Have you met or crossed paths with, or even heard of someone who's actually made a visit to the homeland?
No, I haven't.
Neither have I. In which case, I would imagine that... But no, surely not. Can it really be that no citizen of Lenegas has ever been there?
Hold up, what are you getting at, Dohalim?
Assuming what I believe to be correct, it's possible that no one on Lenegas has ever laid eyes on the actual Renan homeworld itself. No one but the Sovereign, that is.
But what about trade and communication? There's got to be a flow back and forth, surely.
Not if the Sovereign is imposing his will on Lenegas single-handedly. It could be a one-way street.
But I thought you said that the Sovereign's all the way over on Rena. If that's the case, can he really rule directly over Lenegas from so far away? What if something were to happen to the city, like now?
I'm beginning to wonder what the nature of this Sovereign even is. Alphen said he was forced into the role, right? Just before the ceremony. But Sovereign is also the title given to the almighty Renan ruler. So which one is it?
Whoever wins the crown contest inherits the throne from his or her predecessor, before becoming ruler over all of Rena and Lenegas. Thereafter, that individual is known as the Sovereign. Though, it would appear that the current ruler has gone silent. As for how Volron factors into all this, at this point, I no longer know what to believe.
3 centuries ago, I became the Sovereign here on Lenegas. No. Not just became, I was forced to. Me, a Danann. 300 years later, we cross paths with Volron, who also bears the Sovereign's crest. That's not the only thing we have in common. We both became Sovereign without winning the crown contest.
Do you think Volron was made Sovereign for the same reason? Because of that ceremony?
I can't say for sure, but it certainly sounds like it.
But that would mean that 2 sovereigns would need to exist at any one time. One whose job it is to rule, and the other for ceremonial purposes. We never did see Volron's body back in Ganeth Heros. Is a new ceremony underway with Volron at its center this time? Could that be what's causing all this strange activity here?
Wait a second. You don't think Volron and the Red Woman are working together, do you? The ceremony can't go forward without the Renis Alma. The same one that the Red Woman stole.
There's something else the ceremony needs. A maiden. And unless there's another one out there aside from me...
Questions, questions, and yet more questions. Ones that it seems will remain unanswered until we can establish the Sovereign's identity.
If the Forbidden Zone really is off-limits to everyone but the Sovereign, that seems as good a place as any to start. For the sake of liberating Danna, too.
Then it's decided. That's where we need to go.
One of the citizens mentioned a passage that she thought might lead to another section of the city. It could point us in the right direction. Do?
Faria.
Faria? Isn't that the person that Avakir guy was-
Shh! But why are you here? Wait. Don't tell me you've given up on the crown contest and come crawling back home from Danna already. Nothing to say? Even though you were willing to kill Tarnagin to secure your position as Lord, you still... kill?
I'm here to take care of something. If you wish to continue this conversation, I only ask that you wait until I'm finished.
Oh, of course. You always did prefer to take the coward's way out. Even after 7 years and living on that Danann rock, you haven't changed one bit. But let me tell you, I haven't changed either. Not a day's gone by the past 7 years that I haven't hated you.
If killing me will bring you peace, then so be it.
Dohalim, what the hell are you saying?
First, I have business to take care of. If it's vengeance you seek, I will grant you it. But you must wait. My sins are legion. Let me finish what I came to do. Then you have my word. I will let you do whatever brings you peace.
Sure, that's it. Run away like always. You don't even have the courage to die. No wonder you leave it to someone else. You're just a coward!
Dohalim. I apologize that you had to witness that.
Is it true? What she said about you killing someone?
Each of us have our pasts. I am no exception.
Before, back in Menencia, you mentioned having taken a friend's life over the throne. Is that what she meant?
The mistakes I made there were not my first, and may not be my last. I will say no more.
Did you mean what you said? About letting her take your life if she wanted to?
She has more right to my life than anyone.
But you can't just...
Whatever happens, I have sworn to put an end to the crown contest, and to ensure continued coexistence in Menencia. I have no intention of expiring before I do so. There are far too many questions I still seek answers to. Besides, you have just as much reason to kill me as she does.
Dohalim!
Forgive me. Some things are best left unsaid.
Wow, this place is beautiful!
Yeah, it must be some sort of rest and leisure area for the locals.
You think? Man, these Renin sure know how to live it up, don't they?
Is something the matter, Dohalim?
Before I went down to Dana, my friends and I, we used to gather at this very spot and play music together. Avakir, Faria, and Tarnigan. That was a lifetime ago now.
Tarnigan. He was the one that Faria mentioned, right?
He was once my dearest, closest friend. As well as Faria's betrothed. Despite Faria's lower class upbringing, she possesses a tremendous talent for music. Entranced by her playing, I helped her overcome her sense of inferiority and introduced her to Tarnigan and Avakir. It was a time of great joy. Four people bound only by their love of music, with no care for social standing. Only the next song, the next melody.
A friendship based on mutual respect, and a society where everyone is a prisoner to their social class. You really are different, Dohalim.
I suppose it's natural you would see it as strange.
I would have, once. Now, I think the idea of breaking away from society's constraints and choosing your friends based solely on affection is something beautiful that's worth cherishing. Besides, it was that way of looking at the world that laid the foundations for coexistence in Menencia.
Your praise does me too great an honor. I was merely following the wishes of my own heart. And even then, it only lasted until the crown contest began. After that, Tarnigan and I became fierce competitors for the position of Lord. Tarnigan had fallen for Faria. By becoming Lord, he aimed to wrest her from her humble origins and raise her to the highest echelons of society. But fate was not so benevolent.
What happened?
Tarnigan was no match for me in combat. On a level playing field, he wouldn't have stood a chance. But he was desperate and low on options, and he couldn't stand the thought of defeat.
You mean he resorted to dirty tactics to try to win, right? But then why does Faria think... Wait, don't tell me she doesn't know.
How could I tell her? Combined with the trauma of losing her beloved, and by her friend's hand, no less, she would have been devastated.
So instead you let her go on hating you, so she could use that hate as a crutch for her grief?
That's not the same as running away, though.
It is exactly the same. Unable to face the loss of my friend and the burden of my duty, instead I decried my fate and looked away from what I'd done. As for what happened after, that you already know.
But if you hadn't become Lord, Menencia wouldn't be what it is now. The Danans there would still be suffering under Renan oppression like before.
Xion's right. What other lord would have treated me as you did? Anyone else and I would have been dead long ago. You've saved so many people, Dohalim. You saved me. It's thanks to you that I'm here today. So, try not to blame yourself. The burden you've placed on your own shoulders is too much for anyone to bear.
Frank as always. But I shall do my best to heed your advice. Do you think he'll be all right?
Yeah, I think so. He's got Kisara.
It's important to have someone like that.
I didn't realize how difficult it is just to be there for someone.
Sometimes just knowing someone's on your side can be enough. And he knows, Xion. I promise he does.
I hope you're right.
This must be it. The entrance to the Forbidden Zone.
But it's just a wall. How do we get through?
Whoa-wee! I thought this was Sovereigns only.
Alphen.
Interesting. If Alphen's presence still opens the way, it would seem the Sovereign of 3 centuries ago and now are considered one and the same.
What?
What the?
Alphen.
You again.
Tomorrow's the spirit channeling ceremony. We'll finally play our parts as the Sovereign and Maiden. How have you been feeling?
What am I Sovereign of? Shuffled from lab to lab, always treated like an experiment. Whenever they look at me, all they see is a Danan. I don't even know what their precious ceremony's for, let alone what they're going to force me to do as the Sovereign. Tell me, if we're both in the same boat, why do you seem so calm right now?
No choice. Becoming the Maiden's not something I wanted for myself. But they said Renna's prosperity depended on it. How could I say no after that?
Still, as a Renan, at least you got to decide. Good for you. Meanwhile, I was taken from my homeland. You aren't the captive one here.
It isn't right what they did to you, and I'm sorry for what it's worth. When this is over, I swear I'll help you get home. I can't do this alone. One more day.
How could I say no to that? It's not like I have any choice in the matter anyway. So, what's your name?
It's Naori. Naori Imeris. Try to remember this time.
You don't act like them. Like the other Renans, I mean. How come you treat me like a person?
Because you are. It's true we come from different worlds. But neither one of us asked to be here right now. In that sense, you and I are much the same. We couldn't do this. We wouldn't be able to talk to each other as people. If we didn't see the humanity in each other.
So I suppose the question you should be asking is, why wouldn't I treat you like one?
You're not like the others.
Maybe they're not like me.
Here's what we'll do. We give them their damn ceremony. You get me to Dana. That'll be the end of it. I'm taking you at your word on this. I'm trusting you, not them. Naori.
What the hell just happened?
That vision. Did everyone else see it too?
That person Alphen was speaking to. She looked exactly like Shion.
It was Naori. Naori Imeris. Isn't that right?
Yeah, that's right.
She really does look like Shion. I'm beginning to see why Alphen was so confused.
That's all very well and fine, but what did we just witness exactly? It was too real to be a mere hallucination.
It was a conversation we had 300 years ago, the night before the ceremony.
You mean all of that really happened? We just saw an episode straight out of your past?
But how is that even possible? Unless... could this be the Red Woman's handiwork too?
No, I don't think so.
Why not?
You guys didn't feel it? The moment the entrance opened, it was like a stream of Danan astral energy rushing over us.
I felt it too. And not for the first time either. It was the same sensation as back inside the Wedge.
That would make sense. After all, vast amounts of Dana's astral energy were being siphoned and sent up here to Lenegas. For all we know, perhaps we're close to the spot where all that energy was stored.
So you think it might have been the energy itself that was responsible for that vision we just saw? But how? And why?
We have no way of knowing. Maybe it's not even as deliberate as all that.
Shion, you okay?
Yeah. It was all just a little sudden. That's all. So that was my ancestor, huh? It was like looking into a mirror.
Yeah, there certainly is a resemblance.
What about you? How are you holding up?
Me?
Even putting aside the question of where that vision came from, it's likely we'll see more of those. Reliving painful episodes from your past. Do you think you can handle it?
I can't just pretend like the past never happened. Besides, if it helps us uncover the truth of what that ceremony really was, it might also lead to answers about your thorns.
Alphen.
That's not all. This whole time, we've been fighting to free Dana from the Renans. But now that we're here, it seems those same Renans might have it just as bad. I'd like to liberate them too, if I can. Which is just another reason I can't afford to shield my eyes from the truth.
Whether you're on Dana or somewhere else, you always stay the same. Your indignation and righteous passion, your desire to free and protect, they're all hardwired into you. Not that I'm complaining. Come on, let's bust this thing wide open.
Faria, how did you get in here?
Wait, something about her isn't right.
What's wrong with her? She doesn't even seem to know where she is.
Yeah, you're right. She looks just like the soldiers we encountered outside.
Dohalim!
Forgive me. Man, I thought we were goners.
Everything okay?
Yes. She's only unconscious.
Not her. I meant you.
Shion, please. Can you treat her?
I can try, but I can't promise she'll be back to her real self when she wakes up. All I can do is heal her physically.
We're not even supposed to be in here. Maybe it'd be better if we moved her to somewhere a little safer. Don't you think?
In that case...
I'll take her off your hands.
You?
Avakir, what are you doing here?
I was curious what you were up to, so I took the liberty of following you to find out. I overheard what you said about Tarnagan, about how he really died. I'm sorry, I had no idea.
And you believed me? What makes you so sure I wasn't lying?
I like to think I know you a little better than that, Doh Halim. Give me some credit. I'll take Faria. Leave her with me. I know better than to ask what you're up to, but whatever it is, I hope it all works out.
Thank you.
He seems like a good friend.
He hasn't changed. He never was one to stand out. Instead, he was always hanging back, worrying about everyone else. As for Faria, it's always the closest to me who get hurt.
You don't seriously blame yourself for what happened to her, do you?
Somebody got to her, to strike back at me. Someone who knew me well enough to know that I'd hesitate to fight back. And the same goes for you as well. Neither you nor Faria would have lost loved ones if it wasn't for me.
You're wrong. Kel'Zalik was the one who killed my brother, under orders from Almadria. As for Tarnagan, if it weren't for the crown contest, he'd still be alive. That and the whole damn hierarchy that makes it possible. But that's why we're fighting. To put an end to this whole messed up system that treats people as expendable.
Indeed. Ridding society of this blight is really the only way I know how to atone for my sins.
You can't atone, Doh Halim. I know it hurts to hear, but those people are dead. No amount of soul-searching or trying to make amends is going to change that. Forgiveness, acceptance, those ships have sailed.
So I just forget the harm I caused?
No, the opposite, in fact. You remember. You never forget. You keep it in your heart always. And then you go on living. Not for those already passed, but for those still alive.
For those still alive.
Kisara's right. So long as we've still got breath in our bodies, we can make a difference in the lives of others. Lives being the operative word.
That's what living's all about. Being able to still make a difference. Punishing yourself for the past won't make the pain of your conscience go away.
Only fixing the problem in its stead. Is that what you're saying?
That's right. You have to live for tomorrow, Doh Halim, not for yesterday. And not only that, you need to live for yourself, and for the change that you still can be.
I shall try.
Don't forget, we've still got a mystery to solve. The Forbidden Zone, remember?
Shion.
Huh?
Thank you. You have my deepest gratitude for what you did for Faria.
Glad to be of service.
What is it, Rinwell? Do you hear something again?
Yeah. It's that voice.
The will of Dana's astral energy.
What? There's so much astral energy. But where's it all coming from? It's almost like... It's alive.
That was the spirit channeling ceremony just now. No, it was more than that.
What the hell was that? It felt like everything was on the brink of... like the whole world was seconds from...
Oblivion. It's the same vision as the one my thorns show me. A vision of impenetrable darkness that swallows up us and everything else.
An empty void. A nothing so complete and dominating that there aren't even words to describe it. The end of time.
The visions of the apocalypse you've been seeing. If I'd known how bad they were, I...
So, everything we just saw, those were Naori's memories, right?
That's right. It was as if her innermost thoughts were speaking directly to us. At least I know they weren't mine.
That power flowing into her... it reminds me of Shion's thorns. If they're what's responsible for all these visions she's been having, then maybe...
maybe my thorns are made from that same astral energy?
If that is the case... we just found the missing link between your thorns and what happened here 3 centuries ago. No, more than a link. Perhaps even the very heart of the matter.
I've never felt astral energy so powerful. What was that?
If it's the same energy your thorns are made of, it must be dark astral energy, right? And isn't that something only Renans have?
Correct. Dark astral energy is possessed by Renans alone.
And when enough astral energy gathers together, it develops its own form of sentience. If so, maybe that complete oblivion is exactly what the Renan astral energy's will is wishing for. But why?
I don't know. Will can be a pretty vague thing to nail down. It's more of a feeling. Just like the will of Dana.
But the will of Dana is made up of astral energy too, right? And if that's what's been showing us these visions... I don't know, should we really be getting so involved with this thing?
Dana's will would never want oblivion!
But you can't say that for sure!
Cut it out, you two. Squabbling over theories will get us nowhere.
Let's keep moving. If it's Dana's will showing us these memories, then I'm as clueless about its motives as any one of us. But if it could lead us to the truth... then I want to find out more.
Shion's right. All we can do is keep going. If these really are Naori's memories we're watching, there could be truths in them I was never aware of. And I think they may be the kinds of truths I need to confront if we're going to keep fighting.
I'm sorry about what I said earlier. Come on, let's go.
This looks like some kind of research facility.
A laboratory secreted away in the Forbidden Zone. Why am I past being surprised at this point?
Well, can you make head or tail of it?
These are experiment records, by the looks of it. Reams of them, dating back hundreds of years. Let's see. A composite being capable of controlling Danon astral energy, so as to convert its molecular and elemental makeup. The creation of a governing central figure, taking the form of a Danon. Codename Sovereign.
Sovereign?
Wait, there's more. Research into utilizing force field crystals for the purpose of stable astral energy containment. That must be the master course. With all this raw data, there's bound to be records here somewhere about the Maiden and the Lords, too.
About the Lords? Why would they be on there?
Think about it. The Lord's crests are clearly of a piece with those of both the Sovereign and the Maiden. Not to mention the fact that the contenders to the crown are selected from otherwise regular Renan citizens. In other words, it may be that all Renans are unwittingly being made subject to some kind of grand scheme.
What about the Sovereign? Does it say anything else?
Where do I start? All I've read so far is the headlines. There's so much here. To sift through all of it would require specialized... Wait.
What is it? Did you find something?
It's a list of names. With the title, Test Subjects, Sovereign. It's your call.
Read it.
There must be dozens of test subjects listed here. Hundreds even. All of them failures. Wait. I think I've found one that was successful. Test subject number 1273. Ethnicity, N.A. Unique Adjustment Index, Generation, N.A. Given name, Alphen.
They re-engineered me. Right here in this lab.
Alphen.
It's fine, really. What about the others? Was I the only one?
Test subject number 10105. Ethnicity, N.A. Unique Adjustment Index, Generation, N.A. Given name, Volron.
Volron? But that means...
He's only Sovereign because someone made him that way, too.
He's the last one. In 3 centuries worth of records, you and Volron are the only 2 subjects on whom the experiment was a success.
But what about the winners of the crown contests? Does this mean that none of them were ever crowned sovereign after all?
Upon victory, the Sovereign shall return to Renna and rule over Renna and Lenegas combined. When a new Sovereign is decided, the outgoing monarch shall relinquish their post and live out the rest of their days on Renna. So we were told. But according to these records, there have only ever been 2 Sovereigns, neither of whom had anything to do with the crown contest. It's all lies, including the part about the Sovereign residing in Renna. The crown contest was never about deciding a new ruler. It must always have been devised for some other purpose.
But even supposing that's true, someone must have been in charge for the past 3 centuries, right? If it wasn't the Sovereign, then who was it?
Crown contests have been held this whole time, in spite of the fact that there was already a Sovereign, me. Meaning that for the past 300 years, someone out there has to have been maintaining that lie. The same person I'm willing to bet is behind all this.
The Red Woman? It's possible. But that doesn't necessarily mean she's the mastermind behind this scheme. She could be working for someone else. Someone back on the Renan homeworld.
Either way, it's fair to say she's definitely involved somehow.
What about the data records? Is there no other information that could help us?
Not that I can see. Just file upon file of experiment results. There's nothing here about who's behind all this, or what their endgame is, unfortunately. I've barely managed to scratch the surface, mind you. You won't be able to read through it all, but you're welcome to take a look through what you can, while we're here.
I'll do that. Mayuri, I...
Don't talk. I have to do this. I gave you my word that I'd help you return to Dana. The next time you open your eyes, you'll be home.
But you...
My place is here with my people. I still have a duty to fulfill. I'm sorry for what you've endured. Renan never should have dragged you into this. It's not your burden to bear.
But...
The mask contains a sedative. It should keep your mind from tearing itself apart any further. Let yourself go to sleep. This should help with the pain. Time to go, Elfin. Farewell.
Mayuri.
His injuries are worse than I thought. Short-term treatment isn't going to cut it. I'll have to switch the healing pod to long-term hibernation mode. The chance of surviving hibernation's less than 10%? And worse, long-term use of the mask carries a high risk of damaging his mind and nervous system. But... Lenegas will be nothing but ashes, and this starship along with it. I don't know if I can fulfill my promise to you, Elfin. But if doing this will grant you even the slightest chance, I have to try. I hope it's enough. Please, live for me, Elfin.
That vision. It must have been from when Naori helped Elfin escape Lenegas.
She sure went above and beyond the call of duty.
Even with Lenegas crumbling down around her, she chose to stay put with her people.
So that's why you lost your memories and sense of pain, and why you were asleep for that whole time. It was all the result of one agonizing decision Naori made to save your life.
Yeah. If it weren't for her, I wouldn't even be alive today. I owe her everything. More than I could ever hope to repay.
Now that you know how she felt, how do you plan on honoring her wishes?
She kept her promise. If the Renan people she fought so desperately to protect are at risk from a malevolent force, then I owe it to her to carry on her fight.
This place... we've seen this in one of Naori's memories.
Of course. After 300 years... this is where it was held, the spirit channeling ceremony. This is where the Renis Alma was.
So this is the place where you and Naori...
The Renis Alma isn't here now. Nor is the Red Woman, it seems.
I know it's difficult, Alfin, but there will be time to dwell on the past later. For now, we need to keep moving. Come on.
Naori.
What is this? Is it the work of Dana's will again?
It's been a year since the ceremony. That day, I shut away inside of myself the power that caused Alfin to lose control. Since then, my visions of the future have grown more and more fearsome.
Is this another memory? No, it's different this time. It's like she's speaking directly to us.
What we did back then. Not so much as a day passes when I don't think about it. About what was done to us. All in the name of a ceremony. The purpose of which we were never even told. As Sovereign, they linked Elfin's consciousness to Lenegus itself. The Renis Alma was intended to control his power, lest anything should slip through its cracks. That day, as Maiden, my role was to temper his power. I was meant to guide it forth, and give shape to the strength inside of him.
Linked to Lenegus itself? But then, everything that's been happening...
But that power showed me a vision. A vision of oblivion. When I realized that vision was a prophecy of the apocalypse we were about to unleash, I couldn't go through with it. But without a Maiden, the ceremony was doomed. Alfin lashed out, his consciousness no longer his own. I did what I could. Using my abilities as the Maiden, I tried to seal that power away inside of me. But it was too late. Lenegus had already been brought to its knees. Thousands upon thousands of lives so cruelly snuffed out. All because of me. Because of what I had done. With the destructive force now slumbering inside of me, I knew I had to find a way to dispose of it. Anything to make up for my failure. But I didn't know how. Especially since that power was astral energy itself. In which case, ironically enough, the Renis Alma seemed to be my best bet. That, at least, would hold the astral energy dormant. Assuming that no malevolent third party got to it first. With the Sovereign and Maiden's combined power, perhaps I could shift the chaotic energy inside me into the Renis Alma instead. That's what I hoped, but alas, it was not to be. The Renis Alma was lost, and Alfin the Sovereign was in a starship bound for Dana. My only choice was to seal away the destructive force inside of me using my powers as the Maiden, to buy the world what little time I could. The time needed for a new Renis Alma to be crafted, and for a new Sovereign to appear. Even if by doing so, it meant I would be passing the curse onto my descendants as well. Please, forgive me. I never meant to burden the future world with this threat, too. I only wish that there was something more I could have done.
Wait, you can't just...
Naori.
That message just now, was it directly from Naori? Or was it the Danann voice speaking through her?
What?
These are the clothes that Naori and I wore during the ceremony 3 centuries ago.
So you're saying this is the maiden's outfit?
That's right. These clothes are designed to resonate with the sovereign and maiden's abilities. They focus and enhance them.
And they appeared now because...
Naori must have left them here for the new sovereign and maiden, knowing the day would come when they would need them in their fight against the Thorns.
These outfits are directly linked to the answers we've been chasing this whole time. If they're here, it must mean it was Naori's will for us to find those answers as well.
Locating the Rennis Alma would allow us to neutralize the dark astral energy inside Shion, thereby silencing her Thorns. Is that what Naori's suggesting?
It makes sense. After all, Master Cores and Spirit Vessels are both able to prevent the astral energy inside them from developing sentience. By that logic, it would stand to reason that the Rennis Alma would have the same ability on a larger scale.
We have a maiden and sovereign. Now all we need is the Rennis Alma, and we'll finally be able to free you of your thorns. Shion.
It's possible? You really think so?
I do. We can rid you of your thorns and stop the world from falling to oblivion.
However, the spirit channeling ceremony already failed once. Even if our goal is different this time, we can't be sure the same thing won't happen again. We should take care not to be too optimistic.
You're right. It's the barest sliver of a chance. But if there's even the slightest hope it can work, I'm willing to stake everything I've got on it.
I know it's too early to let myself feel relieved, but I just can't seem to help it. Just hearing there's the slightest chance, even though I know the world's still in great peril, it's selfish of me, I know, but still.
No, it isn't! You found hope to believe in. It'd be strange if you weren't over the moon about it.
Rinwell's right. We can rid you of your curse and still save the world at the same time.
Thank you. Naori entrusted us with the fate of all humanity. Now, it's up to us to prove that trust was well placed.
Starting with a little game called Hunt the Rennis Alma.
Yeah, we've come all this way. Now we just need to search Lenegas and Renna until we find it.
Yeah, we can protect the world and save Shion at the same time.
I too shall lend my services. My knowledge of Renan lore is bound to be a useful asset.
And they say modesty is dead.
Miracles just seem to follow wherever you go, huh?
How do you know it's me they're following? We're all in this together, Shion. You included. Now let's get moving, shall we? Last I heard, we had an apocalypse to stop. Thank you, Naori.
That's quite some door, all right. This might finally be it. The heart of the beast.
We'll find the Rennis Alma and the Red Woman inside, right?
After everything we've been through to get here, they damn well better be.
We'll probably be needing you to open this one for us, Sovereign.
Go for it, Alphen.
This is it, guys. Time to see what secrets are in store.
Volron! He really was still alive.
And there's the Renus Alma. Then, is this another spirit channeling ceremony?
Wait, though. Something doesn't seem right here.
All once more, the powers must be united. Born from the fires of chaos, the world does seek its rightful state. All must be sacrificed in the heart of Renna, at the shrine of the true sovereign.
What has happened to him? He's lost himself, reduced to a mere cog in a machine.
Hey, look! Over there!
Isn't that the Maiden's Crest?
Can it be that this entire chamber is meant to act as a substitute for the Maiden?
It looks like it's still running, but are we already too late to stop the ceremony?
If that's what caused Lenegus's transformation, then the purpose of the ceremony must have been to drain all the astral energy out of Danna.
But for what purpose? What could possibly need astral energy on that sort of scale?
I don't know. But whatever it is, I'll bet it's connected to those visions of Oblivion. Regardless, we cannot stand by and let them steal Danna's energy. That said, we should retrieve the Renus Alma. Because right now, we need that most of all.
He's not gonna lunge at us out of nowhere, right?
Not the time, Law.
Alfin, look!
The Red Woman! So we finally found you. I have a lot of questions for you.
Wait!
What?
They all have the same face? How is that even possible?
People?
It's hard to know for sure, but I think they're the true rulers of Renna.